Welcome to top 5% of the people in the world. Yes, this is Ganesan, your millionaire coach and author of the book Money Leaks. And I started doing top 5% people of the world just to make sure you are moving towards the right side of the quadrant of Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad Poor Dad. Yes, so only the 5% of the people make wealth and they enjoy financial freedom because they make their money to work for them. So are you interested to make your money to work for them? So this is the series where it will help you to make your money to work for you, right? So today's topic is all about, is your mutual fund showing negative returns in your entire portfolio? Yes. And you may be wondering, why I have been investing for the last 5 years, I've been investing for the last 7 years, but still how come my fund can be negative? So if this is the question, so probably just a minute. If this is a question running in your mind, this video is for you guys, where I'll help you to understand why your portfolio is negative and how long it may be negative and how far it will take for your fund to show positive returns and multiply your money, right? So let me, without further delay, let me show you an important stat. Okay, this is the important stat. So if you look at the video in the screen, if you're in the first year, the probability of negative returns is 29%. And that too if you are invested at the top and the fund value might be in negative, and that too if you have been investing for the last 1 year, the probability is 29%. And even if you are investing for the last 5 years, the probability of negative returns is 9%, and the probability of positive returns, and that too greater than 12%, is just around 53%. And just think of, if you have been investing for 15 years, either SIP or positive lump sum investment in mutual funds, then the probability of negative returns has become zero after 15 years. And returns between 0 to 8% is 5%. The last two rows you can check. And the probability of between 8 to 12% is 21%, and greater than 12% is 74%. And just look at the 20-year period timeline, the probability of return of more than 12% is 80%. Just look at the way the money compounds in the long term. If you're staying invested for a longer period, automatically the money compounds more than 80%, and that to 12%. And average inflation rate in India, including the lifestyle inflation, is around more than double, 10%, I keep saying. And all your important long-term financial goals, just think of your retirement funding, right? Your all your long-term financial goals, your retirement funding, your kids' education, your kids' marriage life, and anything but long-term, it happens in the long-term. It will be more than 10 to 15 years. If that is the case, just look at investing in all these long-term SIPs, because you may be willing to invest only smaller amounts, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000. And there is a stat like investing 15,000 per month for 15 years. And there is a thumb rule. It's called thumb rule, right? It will work. So let me show you, it's a thumb rule, so it will work. So if you have been investing for 15 years at 15,000 per month, at 15% returns, there is a possibility, then you will be able to make one crore. 15,000 for 15 years, it can be possible to make 1 crore, right? So if that works, just think of, even between 70 lakhs to 1 crore, that's a huge possibility, right? And if you look at the way the cycle works, we had a huge dip during 2000-2001 period. There was a IT tech burst, and between 2008-2009, there was a huge fall. At that time, market was between 21,000 points to 8,000 points and 8,800 points. Slowly, it started climbing up till 2013-14. The market was slowly moving up. It didn't even reach the 2007-2008 peak, 21,000. So from the moment 2014 election started coming up, race started picking up, slowly the market moved up. And if you invested at 21,000 points in 2008, automatically by 2018-19, it had touched 40,000. So just think of, it went for a way below and it went up. So in 12 years, if you have been, if there is a huge fall of more than 15-20%, at that time, if you have been investing a bulk amount, I mean, at least increasing your SIP or putting something extra during that time, can increase the possibility of positive returns quite quickly. Yes, if this you can follow religiously, then you will be able to make a huge sum. You don't need to wait for a longer period of time, right? So let me show the stats again. So this is the possibility. Just look off, in first year, the probability of greater than 12% is 54%. And if you have been investing during the time of when the huge bull rally is happening, so small cap happened And one more thing is, if you have been just following the people, then you may end up in losses. Small cap was doing extremely well between 2015-16, and that news started coming up. People started projecting that small and mid cap was giving huge returns. You should go and invest in that. And by the time the news started coming in, automatically the company started didn't start doing good, and demonetization happened, and then GST implementation happened. And these are certain negative things, because small and mid cap are somewhere during the growth phase, they'll grow extremely well, and if there is a roadblock, automatically they will fall down, or the management needs to be resilient so that they go up. If this is the case, and because of demonetization and GST and all these things that affected the growth of small and mid-cap companies, and because of which during 2017-18 till now, the rally is the companies are not performing at that best, at their best, and people who have been started investing from 2017-18 period in small and mid-cap, automatically the people started feeling that the returns are not good. Should I continue my small cap funds, even if they are the best performing small cap? For example, DSP small cap, if that has been the fund you have been investing, that may not be doing good for the last 1 or 2 years, and you shouldn't withdraw, because they have been following a strategy. Like if there is a huge dip in the small cap portfolio, exact direct equity, then they will put their money huge. And when there is a rally in small cap, they will make sure people are not investing during the rally, and then only when it comes down, you will make money, they will invest again. So it's a peak bottom peak. So that's how the small cap and mid cap works, and that too DSP small cap, they follow the strategy. So if you have been investing in small cap, your period of investment should be more than 5 to 7 years. So if this is the case, probably you may have a positive scenario. So let me show this. And again, this is something like SIP tested between all the stocks, from large cap, small cap, mid cap, and all the categories, and hybrid funds. So in this is mostly with equities, that is when the positivity and more than 12% returns can possible. If you have been investing in debt funds like hybrid or debt funds, the returns may not be more than 10%. So purely in equity point of view, this is working, and this, just look at the ratio. Negative returns will get diminished only beyond 15 years, and between 0 to 8% is always possible if you stay invested for more than 7 years. And when are you taking your money? If you're taking your money during the crisis time, March last week, April, May, it surely will be negative. If you have waited for some time, and if you have been taking right now, and still, because even right now, only the large cap funds like Reliance, HDFC Bank, the large cap funds has been doing good. So if you have been looking at these, analyze the fund, analyze the portfolio, and analyze the market situation, then you should withdraw the funds. And if your goals is very long, say another 5 years, 10 years, then you don't need to panic. You can keep investing, keep adding your SIPs, so that don't worry. Because even if there is a market bottom, you can add your SIPs. So people who are in need of funds, I'm asking them to shift to the debt fund. If they don't need funds in the next 2 to 3 years, no need to worry, no need to panic. You can keep investing, don't worry about all the noises which is happening in the market. My fund is not doing good, all these stuff. Because at the end of the day, if your goal is say 7 years down the line, you don't need to panic. In 7 years, market will always go through a bottom, and it will peak up, and you can enjoy the profits. If you stop, if you pause the fund, or if you cancel the SIP, then you don't know when is the bottom. Because in March and April, people thought the market will go down and it will be prolonged bottom. But the point is, again, market started going up, and nobody knows how the market will react in the next couple of months. And these are short-term things which people cannot predict, but in long-term, market always moves up. And if your goal is say in the next 2 years, it is wise to shift to debt funds. If it is within a year period, it is very good to shift to debt funds, banking and PSU debt funds, or ultra short-term funds. These are safer category, so that in the next 1 year, your fund is protected. You are, though you may be falling short of your goal of say 30 lakhs, but at least you will have 20-25 lakhs. If your goal is within 1 to 2 years period, please start doing that. Please start doing this. If your goal is beyond 3 years or 5 years, no need to panic. Keep investing. Don't stop the SIP. Looking at your financial position. So this is particularly with respect to This video is particularly with respect to why there is a negative returns in my portfolio. Should I stop that? So if you have any questions with respect to this, please post the questions in the comment section. If you like the video, if you want to see the SIP returns in the long term, just check it or just go back and see whatever I said so that you will get a clear picture what is happening in the market and how long should you continue your SIP. Because SIP is not short-term product. SIP is not short-term product, it's a long-term product, not even this much beyond that, right? So it's beyond the 3 months, 6 months, or even 1 to 2 years, it's more than 5 to 7 years, the things had gone changed almost, I can say that, because of the market situations. So if you have any queries, please post your queries to this booking calendar. Go here, book your questions, book your appointment, ask me whatever you want so that I can answer your queries. Thank you so much for listening. If you like this video, please share this video with your friends so that they also know why the portfolio is negative and should I change the funds or should I stop, should I cancel. Thank you so much for watching. Please share this video with your friends.